We're here with LA Times, Dylan Hernandez. Dylan, how are you feeling tonight?
I'm pretty good, I guess. Yeah, I'm done with my work for the day, so that's always a relief.
We're here, Kovalev Ward Media Center. The room was packed before. Now it's kind of, it's later in the day. What was it like to be here for the face-off at a press conference?
I actually wasn't here.
Okay.
I kind of did my interviews earlier in the week, and so I was actually holed up in my hotel room just trying to get that copy out.
So let me ask you this.
Yes.
What do you say about the fight itself? It's 2 days left. Tomorrow's the weigh-in. Saturday's the fight. Ward Kovalev.
You know, I think what makes it interesting is it really comes down to one question, I think, is what kind of fighter is Andre Ward at 32 years old? You know, and this isn't any disrespect to Sergey Kovalev, who I actually think is kind of underrated as a technician. Obviously, you kind of look at his timing, his footwork, I think he's actually kind of underrated in some ways. But I think the reality is that the Andre Ward of 4 or 5 years ago boxes circles around him. You know, now what we've seen, I think, in his last two fights at least, is a guy who, frankly, isn't nearly as mobile as he used to be, you know. And you kind of wonder if, you know, we saw him get hit with shots in the last two fights. And sometimes, yeah, there is this tendency that you have to maybe overreact, right? Because you've seen a guy like never get hit and all of a sudden he gets hit like three times. You're like, oh my God, like what's happening? But it's not hard to imagine Kovalev kind of hitting him, you know. And given Kovalev's power, you start thinking, okay, if he gets hit, what's going to happen? So I think kind of the big question is like, A, does he still have the legs? And if he doesn't have the legs anymore, what types of adjustment is he going to make? You know, is he going to kind of try to fight from the outside, which again, I think is going to be kind of hard if the legs aren't there? Or, you know, is he going to get inside and basically get inside of Kovalev's range? To me, that's kind of the big mystery there. The one thing is that I've covered, my previous job was at the San Jose Mercury News, and I was kind of there covering Ward at the beginning of his career, you know. And the one thing I'd said, you know, obviously I've been covering the Dodgers for the last previous eight years I covered the Dodgers, and you know, a lot's been made about Clayton Kershaw and just kind of how he turns into a different person every day he pitches, you know. And it's kind of this, he's got this intensity that's kind of at a level where even his teammates are afraid to talk to him on the days he pitches. You know, and what I've always told people about Andre Ward is that place that Clayton Kershaw visits every 5 days, Andre Ward lives there, you know. And so if you were to kind of ask me for a prediction, I would on this case kind of like bet on the man. You know, again, I don't know if the legs are there or not. I really don't. But I think I know the guy's character, and the fact also that, right, I mean, we've seen him kind of throughout his career, he's pretty much dictated the tempo of every single round that he's fought.
You know, hasn't lost since he was 12. You're talking about Ward, of course.
Right, and it's not just the fact that he hasn't lost, but it's that he's controlled the tempo, right? Here's a guy that just doesn't give in at all, you know? So when it comes to, I'm betting on the guy, so to speak, at this point. I'm thinking that, you know what, even if Ward doesn't have the legs, you know, even if he might not be the fighter that he was 5 years ago, I just kind of think he's going to figure out a way to win.
Dylan, tell everyone where to follow you on Twitter really quick.
Dylan O. Hernandez, and that's Dylan like Bob Dylan, D-Y-L-A-N.
The Nobel Prize winner?
I was actually named after Dylan Thomas, who's actually the person that Bob Dylan named himself after, you know, because Bob Dylan's real
Zimmerman.
Zimmerman, right? Yeah. And when he took the Dylan thing, he actually got that from Dylan Thomas, so.